it's the guy in a blue shirt without the tie.
Salam
alaikum. Can we say we're very sorry to keep him waiting?
Ghafoor Rakimov is one of the most controversial men in the country. Although he's a successful businessman with interests ranging from cotton to soft drinks, he's been dogged by rumours of involvement in organised crime. But no one has produced any evidence to prove this.
Please come in.
Wow. Isn't this beautiful?
It's beautiful. It's incredible.
It turns out we weren't the only Brit to have visited the mansion. Mr. Rakimov is a keen patron of sports and sponsors the annual Tashkent Tennis Open.
Yeah, he's a winner.
It's a rare occasion when Tim Henman won the competition then.
After a lengthy feast, Mr. Rakimov's entourage showed us a copy of the Australian newspaper from the time he was refused entry into the country. They were keen to show us that their boss was framed and was innocent of all charges.
This document, which they say is forged, reportedly involved in the distribution of counterfeit US dollars in Poland. Also a possibly significant connection with major cocaine smuggling operations.
But it's completely untrue.
Yeah.
But this document, this false document, has it caused you problems for your business? Has it caused you personally?
Yes.
No, but I would like to ask.
Yeah. This document caused you problems in your business and your
life. Yeah, in the business, in the life. Of course, a lot of problems.
Mr. Rakimov then decided not to talk to us anymore, worried that being filmed in such opulent surroundings might give people the wrong idea. We left with promises to attend the annual orphans concert that he sponsors. As promised, the next day we stopped off at the orphans concert, organised by Mr. Rakimov. He funds 35 orphanages across the country, housing 3,500 children. Mr. Rakimov himself was brought up in an orphanage, as was President Karimov. Some say this is why they are such good friends. Shahida advised me to limit my questions to Mr. Rakimov to the orphans concert.
As our president said, president of country said, every man in this country had to do something good. So he's trying to do his best. He said it's not necessary to be so smart to do such simple things.